public comment? Hey, you got it?
Mickey Lyman, Garfield Street. I want to thank the borough for their contribution, or their, contribution that they gave us. We got our three flag poles up now with the flags on them. And now for next year, we are going to have to get new, the military flags, for the different branches of the service.
The original ones are all tattered?
Oh, they ripped, yeah. Yeah, we get 2 years out of them.
What will that cost, Mickey?
It's about $135.
Each, or?
No, for all of them. Yeah, but I think it looks so nice with three flags up there.
It does.
Thank you for your hard work.
Yeah, I had a lot of good help.
One thing I want to add to your comment. We have a fund set up for if anybody wants to donate, they can get a hold of Mickey. We used to have a donation box down there, but I think it's gone. But anybody like to donate, keep the wall going, keep the upkeep going, if you worry.
So there is a private donation?
Yeah, we have.
Set up for that?
Fund, yeah.
I think a lot of people are aware of that.
Is there any funds in it?
Yeah.
Yes, we do have some money in it.
What do you, is there money, don't mean to be?
You know what, I couldn't tell you right now, Paul. Matter of fact, I just got today in the mail, I didn't have a chance to do anything with it. But it's called West Catanning Honor Roll.
Anybody else?
Michael Kinsman, 363 Butler Road. I'd like to suggest a public comment whenever we make it, if the public could sign in. That way, from the last incident, whenever two crew was here, they didn't know what to do, and if I could present this, you can use it.
And we have talked about this before, Mr. President.
Yeah.
And I think it's time to implement this. And in my viewpoint, if you don't sign that prior to the meeting, you don't talk. Now, two crew, that was an exception, they were unaware of how this was run. But most of the people here who come here all the time know that. If you don't sign that and your subject matter prior to the meeting, then you do not speak.
And,
about that?
Thank you. And by chance, anything with the code book, was there any, is it done, or?
No, it's not. Codification, done about? Yeah, it is not done. Council members are going to have to sit down with the codification book and what was sent back from the codification company who requested certain things that we need to look at, fees, term limits, and that type of thing. And that has not been done. But we have it. We have it. The ball's on our court.
Okay. Thank you. And one last thing. I did contact Bobby Bauer to see what he can do about the culvert, the hole over at Butler Petroleum property. And he did look into it a little bit for me. And which, are you guys aware that they're under bankruptcy? Okay, which at this point, money is supposed to still be there in some kind of fund where it's still gonna be rectified. So, but I do appreciate where I was able, Bobby was able to get back to me. He got some information for us, so.
Does that mean we have to file new charges against BP, or are current charges still hold?
Not from my understanding, no. Everything's still a go.
Okay.
And they're supposed to take care of the problem.
I told Nancy called me and said, "What you call?" And I didn't know what else you wanted. I can't call and tell the DP you have to do this. Okay. Like I told them, have you called? We get more people calling, they're going to push it. But I know for a fact that the permits were issued, and last I talked to Arlene Evans, she said that they were soliciting bids for it. Now, somebody said they seen a couple people over there, a couple guys over there one day. If that's what they were there for, I don't know.
They were over there, they had a tape measure out, and as I was explaining to Nancy about this, broad daylight, I mean, I was amazed. You think some people would have a little bit of discretion? Urinating right there in open view. I'm thinking, are you kidding? But they did do a measure around the barriers. And so I don't know what you know, if they're talking about putting a fence up or something right
now. I mean, it's basically right now in between DEP and Butler Patrol.
Now, my biggest concern when I called Nancy too, believe it or not, underneath there already, and I took some pictures, it's already starting to dam up. There's, you know, like limbs and everything that's, you know.
More debris in that channel coming through there.
Yeah, and, you know, I'm not trying to be like a jerk picking on anybody, but there's a ball down in there. A little kid, you know, still the kids pass through there for a bus stop. Little kid, hey, I want a ball. You know, they're going to try to possibly get down in there. I just said, why can't they just put a temporary fence up? I know when we did major construction on my property, you know, not at this facility, but we rented a fence. It cost us about $125 to $150 a month. And that's my only suggestion. I think we should at least force them to put some kind of fencing around it, more appropriate than what's around our building.
Is that debris still in there?
Yes.
After the last rains?
Yes.
Well, he's saying that you should force Butler Patrol to put a fence up.
I mean, if you want to say, I mean, I guess if you thought of it as a dangerous structure, I mean, you could do something, but from my understanding, no one's actually ever going to be able to get a hold of someone from Butler, especially now, if they file for bankruptcy. You'll never reach anyone. It would have to be done probably by Aurora. And I don't know, what is the DEP, what is their deal? I mean,
well, like I said, the last I talked to her was the permits were mailed out October 23rd to the Butler Patrol.
And they're forcing them to do this?
Yes. And she told me that, well, then I called her a week later, and she told me that she contacted Butler Petroleum, and they stated to her that they were in the process of getting bids to have it fixed.
Butler Petroleum?
Butler Petroleum, yes.
And then nothing since then?
No, that's it.
And obviously, they could have filed for bankruptcy.
If they did, and that's it. I'll call her again and see what I can find out this weekend. See what she tells me. Like I said, it wouldn't hurt for me to call you. I mean, you know, call and express your concerns.
It's very mind-boggling because whenever I got this all started back, whenever Fred Bonello owned the restaurant, you'd think at that time they just would have made the whole piece be cleaned up. And unfortunately, no, they just made that part of it instead of us, you know, coming up through. But that was hell going through DEP at that time. I mean, all the runaround and
did
everything.
Did you give them that number?
I did.
Yes.
If you call her and you leave a message, she'll get back to you. It might be a couple days or 3 days later, but she will get back to you.
And I said perhaps if a concerned citizen also the contacting
maybe
it might have some blood cover, you know, that might get them to stay.
I mean, just so the residents know,
with
this past summer, with all that rain we had, if we wouldn't have got it cleaned up down below at Benellis, we would have had that nightmare all repeating from what we had in the past. And that proves, because you guys are familiar over the years of how it always kept flooding down there. And, you know, but it was a battle.
All right, thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
I forgot to tell you, Thursday night, this Thursday at 7 o'clock, we have crime watch.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm bringing cookies.
You're bringing cookies?
Yeah. Well, yeah, I need a motion.
What time was that?
7 o'clock.
No more public comment. I need a motion for minutes.
Can I make that motion, Mr. President?
Second? Any questions? All those in favor, raise your right hand. Mayor's report.
For the police, there were 22 traffic citations issued for warnings and one for bus violations. And non-traffic citations issued with disorderly conduct and one for bad checks. Two DUIs on criminal charges. Possession of material possessions of drug paraphernalia, two possessions of government products and property, theft of property. An ordinance we were conducting notice and investigations with regard to the vehicle parking ordinance that has been adopted. And for public notice, since the holiday season, there are always individuals who are looking for open doors, packages left on porches, and items in vehicles. Please be sure to protect your valuables. There are also two scams that are going around via phone or internet. They target the actors are pretending to be someone that you know, if they are advising that on the internet, advising that you have some type of winnings, or that they're acting as a public utility and telling you that you need to send them money prior to your services being shut off. Please check with those individuals. In other words, if it is a notice you're receiving from somebody who is portraying themselves as an individual, possibly off of your Facebook or your friends or notice page, contact them directly and find out if they are in fact notifying you of these things. If it is a public utility, you can contact the utilities direct and make sure that the information that they're giving is correct and find a shutoff notice. There are generally shutoff notices posted on doors or at homes for any type of utility service that's going to be in disconnect. So at that point in time, you can contact them directly. They will be able to give you good information. If they fail to do so, then you know that it's a scam. That's it.
Thank you, Bob.
The only thing I have is I was approached by a resident. The playground of the football field needs either some mulch put in or some other type of material. It's pretty well rotted away. So there's plenty that's turned into mud. I told her maybe in the springtime get something put in there. I don't know, mulch or something, artificial mulch.
Well, resident who lives down there said he was going to look into it.
Who?
At his cost?
No, he's going to look into it to find out what we can get to put in there. Okay. You can't put rubber in there because it's detrimental to the kids. You got to watch what kind of wood chips you do put in there. They have to be finely ground up and so they don't get splinters and so on.
That's all I have.
All right, we'll move on to committee reports. Public Works.
At this time, we're all prepared for winter. We are going into a winter work mode. And it's working out reasonably well. We do have a problem with the 97 Ford dump truck. It went over for inspection today, failed. It needs 8 springs on the rear end. It needs new brakes on the front. And the lighting system on the back for solding. The wires are all corroded, most of them are corroded off. It's one of our most reliable trucks.
How many miles is on that?
I don't know. I didn't see how many miles are. I got this call after 3:30 and I didn't even think about it.
Well,
but we have to have it. I mean,
my opinion, we need to put it out for bids, see what it's going to cost to repair it. If it's our workhorse, then.
It's our workers.
What's the other third one? Is it?
It's the leaf spring.
No. We have the new one, the 97.
GMC.
GMC?
Yeah, GMC.
It's an 06.
Yeah.
Can you get 3 bids for that?
This is taking a... They took it over to Flynn's where they get everything inspected, and as soon as you went to put it up, the back springs were broken in half.
Both leaves on both sides?
Both leaves on both sides.
Yeah, I hate to get through without getting bids. And Flynn's does a lot of work with us, but still, it could be a very, very bid range.
It's, it's not like we're going to be in
dire straits if it snows. You know, we still have the two other trucks.
We got two trucks.
To bother, so. I would agree with Cliff that we should get bids on it, get everything fixed on it, needs fixed, right? If there's anything else.
Prior to.
I just wondered if there'd be a way that you could ask them if that could be put into like a one-ton suspension.
They have nothing to do with it, right?
Well, it'd be a lot better rather than three quarters one.
I don't know. That's something you'd have to ask.
Is that legal? Would it have to be a definite?
I mean, you could have to ask.
On that?
I mean, you can change the Bob might be able to answer this. He was saying, put new springs on the truck. Instead of using three-quarter ton springs, use one-ton springs. I mean, there's nothing against the law in that, is it?
No, it's just, the load rating is going to be directly comparative to whatever you're licensing it for, so.
Yeah.
Second, it's a three-quarter version.
That vehicle is registered now as a one-ton, it's probably either 18,000 to 21,000. So depending on whatever you guys have licensed.
It's registered, though, it's licensed as a one-ton now.
It could be, yeah. And, you know, like what Bob's saying, with the weight.
Yeah, I get three bids on that. Is this going to be a big difference?
All right, another thing we have, there's a water problem on Hill Street again, which inevitably, it's been there for the last couple of weeks or so. It's where the one that for years Bernie didn't want to take care of. I thought by the old school going down.
Yeah, but well, there was some.
I say move, Mr. President, to adopt.
And I have a second. Any questions? Any motion in the budget? All those in favor, raise your right hand. All right, I need a motion. This was advertised. To adopt the non-traffic violation ticket ordinance, which was advertised in the paper and discussed at the last meeting. Questions on the ordinance? If not, all those in favor, raise your right hand. Any other unfinished business?
and the total comes to 403.67 minus, will be taken off tax at 22.85 because their computer forgot and they didn't give us some back in terms of form, so I have to go back over and get the refund.
What was that?
403.67 minus 22.85.
Very good, Cliff.
Could you not have Brian's cut the size?
No, these ones were not cut because they said that they, both of them should fit Fed Center the way they're made. There was only one that was cut.
I mean, cut for length?
No, I think, I believe that you can take them out at the bottom. There should be instructions that you could take it out.
Yeah. Yeah, you can do it yourself.
Did you think of it, man?
Any other unfinished business? Not new business. I need a motion to reappoint Richard Folletti to the WKCM Board of Directors for a 5-year term, effective January 4th, 2016. Any questions?
Exactly, what's the title?
He's just on their Board of Directors for the Westfield area.
Westfield.
Yeah.
And he did that previously, so.
Yeah.
He's already on.
Yeah, we're reappointing.
Yeah.
A, you made a motion, you second it. Any questions? All those in favor, raise your right hand. Okay. You need a motion to reappoint Doug Geiser to the Water Authority for another term. To reappoint Doug Geiser to another term on West Canyon Municipal Authority. Any questions? All those in favor, raise your right hand. And I need a motion to hire Pat Petrowski for, that be for a full day?
It could, we'll say for a full day, then we'll overrun it. It should only be for about a half a day.
Do we know his prices? I mean, do you know his prices that you said $400 to $800? That's what they, you said $400 a half a day, $800 a full?
It could, it varies. He had been charging us between $400 and $800. He's been giving us a break. He's there 4 hours and 15 minutes. He doesn't put the 15 minutes on.
So that's just $400?
Yeah, I think we'll go with $400. It'll be all right.
No, my question is, if he's there for 4 hours, he's charging you.
$400, yeah.
So he's charging you $100 per hour?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I was just.
That's him and machinery.
You want to make, put that in for a motion?
Put in the motion to hire Pat.
Second.
Any questions? For 4 hours?
For 4 hours, okay.
Well, he might need more. You never know, but, I mean, if he's there for 4 hours and he needs a little bit more, you can't, hey, you have to stop at four.
We'll see what's ordered, Russ.
What's that?
He might be a student.
Yeah.
But he's the job.
Okay, you made a motion?
Yeah.
Second.
Second.
Any questions? All those in favor? Any other business? All right, I need a motion to pay the bills.
I just want to make one comment on the people's gas, $48.53. I know that our building loan is expensive, but when that loan's paid off, our gas bill is going to be substantially lower than what was in the past. In the winter months, over $2,000.
That's if when the building loan's paid off, the actual gas isn't 10 times what it is now, the cost.
funny that it's so cheap, but you don't see it coming off in your gas.
Well, I feel like we've got something out of this money now.
Absolutely.
You know, I mean, we have something for our money that we're paying $2,000.
I think that was still the, what we were saving in utilities, like having a utility fund, also the payment each month for the new building.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a finish that people want to see the big hit. I make a motion to pay the bills, Mr. President.
Second. More questions in the bills, any questions?
I got one.
JW Fleming.
W.
JW Fleming, cutting edge, $270.
And that was.
JW Fleming.
That was for the new one.
New what?
Cutting edge.
For the plow.
Yeah.
You can't get it.
Yeah, you can't get it at all.
Can't get it where?
Any other questions? Okay, all those in favor, raise your right hand. Letters, did you read?
Mr. President, before we adjourn, do we have a little bit of silence for Pearl Harbor? And then why? Thank you.
And before. And before we adjourn, I'd like to thank Cliff, Kenny ain't here, he's here, thank you too, for your years of service. I know it's like, I know what it's like.
Oh, it's a thrill, isn't it?
Yeah. So, that said, I'd like to thank you both, appreciate working with you. And hope to see you some times to be.
Oh, don't worry. It's easier to be on that side of the table.
Yeah. You're right there. Okay, with that said, any motion to adjourn? Second. All in favor?
Thank you. You too.